Welcome to the 5 Nighttime Signs of Diabetes You Should Know. Our goal in this video is to help you recognize these often overlooked symptoms so that you can take action and seek proper medical care before it's too late. Did you know that diabetes is often referred to as a silent killer? That's because many diabetes symptoms can go unnoticed. Sure, you may already recognize the main early warning signs of diabetes which can strike during the day, like fatigue, mood swings, and blurred vision. But what is your body trying to tell you about your glucose control at night? It's time to discover what to watch for once your head hits the pillow, because sleeping on these warning signs could end up wreaking havoc on your entire body. Please do us a quick favor, click the thumbs up, and if you like what you see from our channel, be sure to subscribe. Now, here comes 5 Nighttime Signs of Diabetes You Should Know. Certain warning signs of glucose dysregulation are generally easy to recognize, especially since they strike during the day. But at night, you should take note if you notice frequent bathroom visits and unquenchable thirst. Have you heard of nocturia? This is a condition where you feel the need to get out of bed 2 or more times during the night in order to urinate. While waking up to go to the bathroom, even multiple times per night, is a common condition that affects people of all ages, and may be due to a number of issues. It can also be a telltale warning sign of diabetes. Why? Chronic high blood sugar can directly result in the kidneys producing more urine in order to flush the excess glucose out of the body. During the day, it can create the condition known as polyuria, or increased urination frequency. But multiple studies have shown that diabetes is also linked to the nighttime version of this condition, called nocturnal polyuria, or nocturia. In fact, a diabetes care study revealed that type 2 diabetic participants experienced nocturia at higher rates than the general population. And the Journal of Urology found that diabetics with poorly controlled glucose levels were more likely to suffer from nocturia than those with more stable blood sugar levels. Nocturia can also affect type 1 and type 2 diabetics due to diabetic neuropathy, or diabetes-related nerve damage. That's because high blood sugar can damage the nerves which control the bladder, potentially leading to overactivity and increased urination frequency. Meanwhile, waking up in the night to go to the bathroom is closely tied with waking up due to feelings of thirst. Polydipsia, or excessive thirst, can strike diabetics at night for multiple reasons. The first being that increased urination frequency can lead to fluid loss and dehydration. Of course, dehydration causes lack of saliva and dry mouth, resulting in heightened thirst. Plus, high blood sugar may create an osmotic effect in the body, where water is drawn out of muscle cells and tissues and pushed into the bloodstream. This too can trigger sensations of thirst, even at night. Impaired kidney function due to diabetes has also been found to lead to heightened fluid loss and increased thirst. So, if you notice that you are waking up more often to go to the bathroom or for a drink of water, or both, this may be your body trying to tell you that you are on a path towards diabetes. What other nighttime issue linked to hydration may be an early warning sign of diabetes? Stay tuned, that's coming up shortly. First, we've got a gut feeling about this next nighttime sign of diabetes: stomach cramps. While these abdominal pains can affect millions of people for many different reasons, they can also be a major warning sign of diabetes. As we've just discussed, excess glucose in the bloodstream can lead directly to dehydration. It can also cause electrolyte imbalances and changes in certain hormonal responses. These issues can all result in cramping in the stomach area. Plus, diabetics are at an increased risk of developing gastrointestinal neuropathy, or damage to nerves in the digestive tract. This can lead to bloating, abdominal pain, and stomach cramps. Gastroparesis, or delayed stomach emptying, is another condition which can be triggered by high blood sugar levels and gastrointestinal neuropathy. This too can create feelings of cramping in the stomach. So, while nighttime stomach cramps can have various causes, diabetes may be a potential main factor, especially if night cramping becomes common and is accompanied by other related symptoms like excessive thirst. What can your lower body tell you about your nighttime blood sugar? Stick around, because the answer is just ahead. Now, let's not sweat the little things, but we should watch for night sweats. Sometimes your body may just be overheated at night, buried under a mountain of covers. But if you wake up covered in sweat, that may be a warning sign of diabetes. Did you know that type 1 and type 2 diabetics are at an increased risk of nighttime hypoglycemia, or low blood sugar, at night? Prescription insulin and other diabetes medications have been found to lower nocturnal blood sugar levels. A significant drop in blood glucose causes the body to release stress hormones, like adrenaline and cortisol. In turn, this will increase heart rate and respiration, leading directly to sweating. In fact, a diabetes care study revealed that a significant amount of diabetic participants with chronic hypoglycemia reported night sweats as a main and common symptom. A separate diabetes care study found a significant association between nighttime sweating and diabetic autonomic neuropathy, or diabetes-caused damage to the autonomic nervous system. Diabetic autonomic neuropathy can disrupt the body's ability to regulate internal temperature, potentially leading to excessive sweating at night. Plus, night sweating may also be due to diabetes-related weight gain. A study published in the journal Diabetology and Metabolic Syndrome showed that overweight type 2 diabetic participants were more likely to experience night sweats than individuals with lower BMIs. So if you wake up with your pillow or sheets soaked in sweat, you may want to seek medical help to determine if you are suffering from diabetes. What could be the most telling nighttime sign of chronic high blood sugar? Don't ignore the number one overnight symptom of diabetes. That's coming up next. But first, we should take steps to understand the link between diabetes and restless leg syndrome. This neurological disorder is characterized by an irresistible urge to move the legs and is often accompanied by leg discomfort or even pain. It may also create feelings of tingling, itching, or crawling sensations across the skin of the legs, especially during periods of rest or inactivity, like lying down for an extended time. And while RLS can be due to a variety of issues, recent research suggests that it may also be caused by diabetes. Studies show that diabetic peripheral neuropathy, or blood sugar damage to peripheral nerves in the legs, can lead directly to RLS. In fact, a diabetes care study noted that diabetic participants with peripheral neuropathy were more likely to experience restless leg syndrome than those without neuropathy. Plus, new research suggests that diabetes-related metabolic factors may affect the brain and neural pathways involved in RLS symptoms. Meanwhile, studies indicate that restless leg syndrome can also be caused by a deficiency in iron, and diabetics have an increased risk of iron deficiency. So if you notice that your legs are restless at night, it could be a sign of low iron levels or even diabetic neuropathy. Alright, it's time to take a close look at possibly the most serious nighttime sign of diabetes: sleep apnea. Do you suffer from this condition? Actually, even if you do, you may not know it, as sleep apnea is characterized by a partially or completely obstructed airway during sleep, causing brief interruptions in breathing. This can occur multiple times per hour and may last just a few seconds, but it can also go on for over a minute. So, how do you know if you suffer from sleep apnea? It presents as loud snoring, restless sleep, or daytime sleepiness. Other symptoms include gasping for air during the night, morning headaches, waking up with a dry mouth, and insomnia. And though it doesn't necessarily indicate chronic high blood sugar, sleep apnea may still be a very telling early warning sign of diabetes. That's because this condition can be caused by various diabetes-related issues, including excessive weight. Of course, diabetes can lead to weight gain, and excess fat, especially fat accumulation in the upper airway, increases the risk of developing sleep apnea. Chronic high blood sugar can also lead to chronic inflammation, which in turn may lead to sleep apnea. And diabetes can create hormonal imbalances, which may also cause sleep apnea. On the flip side, sleep apnea can lead to changes in certain hormones associated with appetite and metabolism, potentially leading to weight gain. And the repetitive oxygen desaturation and disrupted sleep patterns that come with sleep apnea may contribute to heightened insulin resistance. So, just as diabetes can increase your risk of sleep apnea, having sleep apnea may increase your risk of becoming diabetic. In fact, the Sleep Heart Health Study found that participants with moderate to severe sleep apnea had a higher risk of developing type 2 diabetes. The study also showed that the more severe the sleep apnea, the greater the risk of diabetes. Treatment for sleep apnea includes the use of a continuous positive airway pressure, or CPAP, machine. Studies suggest that regular use of a CPAP machine may not only improve nighttime breathing, it may also improve insulin sensitivity, while reducing the risk of developing type 2 diabetes. So, if you think you suffer from sleep apnea, it is critical to see your doctor as soon as possible. It may help you utilize a CPAP machine to reduce your sleep apnea and your risk of type 2 diabetes.